Thank you, Dheeraj. So hello, everyone. I'm Aditya. And I've been infrastructure and advocacy enthusiast. Dheeraj, can you please move on to the next slide? So I'll give you some background information on how I started participating and contributing to Jenkins Infra. So one day I just actually randomly attended the Jenkins Infra meeting, and it was Mark and Gareth, I think they were discussing about some downtime in Jenkins. And that is when I saw how huge Jenkins is. And the slide that was shown by Mark about Jenkins by the numbers, it has actually, and once you get the feel of how they are actually managing such a huge thing, it's awesome. It just blew my mind. And I was like, okay, now I want to contribute and learn how to contribute to this. So yeah. The Jenkins Infra has a huge code base. Jenkins has more than 300,000 installations. And it is really awesome when you see how it is, you know, distributed around the globe. And every time there's a download, it finds the nearest mirror and downloads from there. So it's just awesome. I cannot stop saying how mind blown I was and how awesome it is. So yeah, joining the infrastructure meeting, the calendar link is shared by Dheeraj in the chat. I think that would be the first step. And that is the step I took as well. And there are many areas that need help. And very recently, and I would also like to add that I had no knowledge of how AKS upgrades are done. I paired with Damien and he was really helpful. He kind of held my hand through the process. He hop on to a meeting, and yeah, I shared my screen. He guided me what to do. I submitted my first pull request for infra. And it is not even, I think it was 2 days back. I am pretty new at this as well. Yeah, Dheeraj, please, can we move on to the next? Okay. So these are some steps that I follow, and I recommend that any newcomer can follow to get acquainted and start contributing to Jenkins. So first of all, there's listening. So attending meetings, some are weekly, some are bi-weekly. I think that is how you get to know. And even it is something from where you can understand, okay, is this something of my interest? Is this something that I can contribute to? Second is learning. Jenkins, as Mark said before, it is completely Java development, and Java was not even it's still not even my primary software development programming language. I'm more of a Python person, but as you can see, I am a GSOC student here, so I do Java. I think willingness to learn is something very important over here. Then comes discussing. One need to be proactive, I guess. You need to ask questions in the Gitter channel, during meetings, the mailing list. So discussing would be the next step. Then pairing. I think everyone is really scared in the beginning when they are, you know, making their first commit, first pull request. And pairing really helps, where some experienced person, maintainer of a plugin, actually guides you through the whole process. So that is important. And then I would come to doing. You need to actually take that initiative and write code. Not just code, actually, like, you know, contribute. So the doing phase of it. And finally, reviewing. And being a newcomer, you are again really scared when you are, you know, pressing that submit review button, because what if you say something and it is too rude? What if it is not giving out enough information to the new contributor at the plugin you are maintaining? Or so that thing. And I just made one code review to the on the project that I am working for, Google Summer of Code, that is conventional commits plugin. And yeah, I was scared as well, but I was sure that even if I made a mistake, there are people having my back, and yeah, everything will be fine. So I would like to encourage everyone to follow these steps and contribute. Okay.